Hi, my name's Carly McElvoy. We're talking about symbols in vocabulary terms today. First thing I want to talk about is operation symbols. And you know that we have addition, multiplication, subtraction, division. Those are operation symbols. But I wanted to mention that when we're talking about multiplication and division in when we get into algebra, we want to use that a little differently. The X for multiplication is a little deceptive because we also use X as a variable. So we'll talk about those in a few minutes. So when I have something like 3 times 5, that does mean 3 times 5, but I can also call that 3 times 5 as a dot. So a dot works for multiplication. Also, I could say 3 and then use a parentheses 5. That means 3 times 5 as well. When I don't have a symbol in between the parentheses, I assume multiplication even if I don't see it. Or I could have the 3 in parentheses with the 5 following it. That means multiply. Or I could have the 3 and the 5 both in parentheses, and that would mean multiply as well. All of these things mean to multiply. So it's operation symbol with a lot of variety. There's other things too. I could use brackets. I could do 3 and a bracket times 5. I could use 3 and the braces times 5. Those are all multiply symbols. What I tend to use for myself is the dot because that's the least amount of writing and we want to be as efficient as possible. So I tend to use this format, 3 times 5 or 4 times 7, I use a dot. And we'll see sometimes you don't need anything at all there because we can assume multiplication. What about for division? Well, division has a lot of different ways we can look at it. Let's say we were talking about 20 divided by 5. That's one way to look at it. We can also say 20 divided by 5. That means the same thing. But we can also say 20 divided by 5 like this, like a fraction. And that's the way we like to do it in algebra. We use it as division. We show things as in fraction form. The fraction bar is actually division. So that's the way that we can use that. Now, when I talk about grouping symbols, what am I talking about? Well, we saw grouping symbols up here, parentheses, brackets, braces. We have parentheses, we have brackets, and we have braces. Most of the time, we use parentheses, I think, because they're the easiest to draw. But if I have a problem like this, let's say I had 2 plus 5, and then I'm like, no, I want to subtract 3 from that. No, I want to take that whole thing and multiply by 4. Then I want to take that whole thing and divide by 2. Then I think I'll take that whole thing and add 1. See how hard that is to read with all those parentheses in it? So what we can do instead is say, okay, I have 2 plus 5. Oh yeah, I would like to subtract 3 from that. But then I'd like to take and multiply that whole thing by 4. So I'm going to use a different symbol to show that easier to read. Now I want to take that whole thing and divide by 2. I could switch back to parentheses. That would work pretty well. Or I could decide at this point I want to add 1 to that whole thing. I think I'll use braces and I'll add 1. This is easier to read because I have very definitely, oh, there's that parentheses that has the 2 plus 5. Then there's the brackets that we're subtracting 3. Then we go back to parentheses, we're multiplying. And so we can start to do step by step a little easier with the different grouping symbols. They all have the same meaning. We could always use brackets, we could always use braces, but we use parentheses because they're easier. That's my dog in the background. That's little Asia. And I don't know why she's barking. Okay, now we have constant terms. Constant terms are just numbers like 7, 1/2, negative 4.5, they're always the same number regardless of what you do with them, wherever they are. So if I have I'll come back to that in a second, I guess. And then we have variables because sometimes we have numbers and we're not sure what it is in that particular time or we have something that can change. For our purposes, we use variables, we use letters. Oh, I already did Y twice. I really like Y, apparently. Any letter that you want. Of course, you don't want to use as your variable O, because that looks like 0. That would be confusing. So if I have something like this, X plus 5, I have an operation symbol, that's the plus, I have a variable, that's the x, and I have a constant term, that's the 5. So this is a constant. This is the variable. And of course, the plus is the operation. So we have an expression. Expression has variables and constants and symbols in it. And those things are, it's important to know the vocabulary of those variables. Now, we don't know what x is. That's a variable because maybe in this problem, x will turn out to be 7. And maybe in another problem, x will turn out to be negative 1/2. The value of x changes depending on the problem. So that makes that a variable term. And the last piece I want to give you for vocabulary for this one is the word, the term coefficient. What if I have something like this, 2y plus 7, and I ask you, what's the constant term? Well, the constant term is right here. Constant term is 7, it's always 7. The variable is the y, but what's the 2? Well, the 2 is the coefficient, because a coefficient is the number multiplying the variable. That's what a coefficient is. So if I have something like negative 4p minus 12, then negative 4 is the coefficient, because that's what's multiplying the variable. P is the variable because that's the letter that we're using for our unknown value. And because there's a minus in front of it, we're going to say negative 12 is the constant term. So we have a constant, we have a variable, we have a coefficient, and all of those things, and we'll have more talk about expressions later. That makes up expressions. Expressions have constants and variables and coefficients and grouping symbols, and those things all come together to make exciting expressions. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.